Hello everyone, welcome back to Swat Studs. Today we are going to look at how to create a mirror illusion in Maya using rayswitch shader and tracelets. As you may have already know, this is based on one of my latest personal works of the same name, The Mirror Illusion. If you're interested, I'll put the art station link in the description and you can check that out in higher resolution. So this is the final output that we are going to create here today. If you're wondering what's special about the method, usually this kind of images are rendered in separate layers and then composited together using a compositing software such as Nuke. But here I have rendered the whole scene in a single layer without using any compositing softwares. And it was done using rayswitch shaders and tracelets. I have already made a tutorial explaining the basics of rayswitch and tracelets, which is already available in the channel. You can get the link from the top right corner of the video as well as from the description. So before moving forward, if you haven't watched it yet, I would suggest to watch it first and watch this after, so that you can understand the workflows better, because I'll not be explaining the theories again here. Also, a humble request to the viewers to help me grow my channel. If you are liking the contents that I'm creating for you, please support me by subscribing to the channel, liking and sharing your thoughts in the comments, and also by sharing it with your friends who are also interested in lighting and look depth. So let's start. So we are here in Maya. This is our final scene, which we are going to render as the final output. And let me explain this scene for you quickly. So we have two assets. One is the king. And if I hide this, you can see at the exact same place, we have the pawn as well. And their geometry will be the mirror. And I have assigned symbol shaders without any textures here. So for mirror, I have created a fully reflective surface, and the frame is kind of metallic. And I also have symbol shaders for the pawn and also the king, which is a simply a different base color. And I'm using a single hdri for this tutorial. The final render which I have done in my personal work was done with an area light as well as an hdri. Since I am not considering this as a lighting tutorial, I am only going to show you the workflow in with which you can create that particular mirror illusion here. So I'm only using a single hdri as the lighting. And for render settings, I am using symbol render settings here. For this, we will not be needing any AOV, so I am removing all of this so that my render can be a bit faster. So let me do a quick render and see what we are getting by default in the scene. So yeah, you can see it's a simple scene, and as always, I have added the denoiser optics so that we can see the render outputs faster without noise. So you can see from here, it's a default scene with a single HDRI light. We are getting shadows from the lighting and shadows from the environment, and we are seeing the reflections of that particular pawn in the mirror. So if I turn on the king, you can see it's exactly on the, if I go to the top view and put the wireframe, you can see exactly the pawn is sitting inside the king's geometry. So let me first set up the pawn geometry here. So I am going to hide the king for now. For the pawn, how it should be working is that the pawn should be visible to the camera, but it shouldn't be visible on the mirror. So if we are doing a compositing in a separate software like Nuke, what we'll be doing is that we'll be rendering the pawn and all the geometries in a single layer first, and then we'll render the mirror in a separate layer with hiding the pawn and unhiding the king. And here, if I turn off the primary visibility, you can get only the mirror separately from here. You can simply create a matte for the mirror and you can mask it and layer it in a compositing software. So that will be the usual method that we follow when we want to create something like this. Here I am going to show you a method where you can create it in a single layer using a rayswitch shader. So for that, first we'll set up the first chess piece and then we'll move on to the other one. So first thing first, I don't want to see it in the mirror. So if I turn off the specular reflections, you can see it's completely removed from the mirror, but the only problem is that the shadows are still there. And also another problem we'll face is that suppose our floor is completely reflective, then you can see that when you are removing the specular reflection of the geometry here, it is getting removed from the floor as well. We don't want that happen because we'll need those specular reflections on the floor so that we don't feel like we are breaking the physical accuracy or physicality of the shader. So let me just make it a bit rougher and I'll maybe decrease the specular IOR so that we are not getting so much distracted there. And now, in order to use the ray switch, as you may have seen on the first ray switch tutorial, we have to create a ray switch shader. But what I want to do is that I want to remove the reflections from the mirror. So first thing first, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to select the shader for the mirror and I am going to assign a ray switch shader onto the mirror. So I am assigning the mirror shader onto all the attributes of the ray switch. So we'll not be using any volume here. So I can leave that as it is, plan. Now I'm going to create an tray set. So what we now we are going to do is that we are going to create a tray set and add the pawn into the tray set and tell the shader to not calculate in its reflections. So for that, first we have to assign a tray set name onto the pawn geometry. So we can come to the Arnold and you can see we have already assigned a tray set name on the pawn here. The tray set name is pawn. So I am going to assign the mirror shader into the pass-through attribute and I'm going to add the tray set name pawn here and I'm going to uncheck the inclusive option. And now let's add this into the camera and see what we are getting. So you can see now we have removed the reflection of the pawn from the mirror without removing the reflection from ground. So another thing is that now we have to remove the shadows as well as reflection of the mirror from the ground, because let me add the speculars back so that I can show it to you clearly. So if you see here, since the ground has some specularity, it will have the reflection of the pawn here. You can see this is not just shadow, it is a reflection. What we have to do now is that we have to remove the shadow and reflection of the pawn from the ground reflection. Now what we have noticed here is that it also has shadow and reflection on the ground here as well. So we don't want to remove it from the actual ground. We want to remove it only from the reflection of the ground on the mirror. So let me add the ground shader or floor shader here. And I'm going to again add a ray switch shader for the ground as well. I'm again adding the floor shader onto the ray switch on all of its attributes except volume, because we are not using any volumetric shaders or volumetric effects here. And now again I am going to create another AI trace set and again connecting the floor shader to the pass through attribute and adding the trace set name as pawn and unchecking the inclusive option. Now I am going to connect this into the specular reflection. So now you can see the reflection and shadows are still here in the render, but it's missing from the reflection. So the first step of our render is complete. We have completely removed the effect of the pawn from the mirror and also from the reflection of the ground on the mirror. So now we can bring the king onto the set. The first thing we can do simply is that we don't want this to be visible to the camera. It only has to be visible in the reflections. So I can simply come to its shape node and turn off primary visibility in the Arnold options. So now the visibility is completely gone from the camera visibility, but I can see it in the ground here. So what I am going to do now is that the first thing you'll notice is that it is also visible on the reflections, but also it is darkening down the pond because it is casting shadows to the pond because it is staying inside the king. So now I am going to do here is that I am going to unlink the shadows of the king from the pond. So I'm going to add the pond material here, and I'm going to create an rayswitch shader again, and I'm going to connect the pond material into all the attributes, connecting the rayswitch into the surface material of the pond geometry, and creating an tray set again, adding the pond material to the pass through. Tray set name should be the tray set name of the king geometry. So I have added a tray set name. We can add king as the tray set name for the king geo. And I'm going to add the same name on the tray set here. Unchecking the inclusive option. Let me add this into the shadows and see if that is working. Seems like it's not working. Let me add it to the camera. And now let me add pond geometry back into the shadows. So now we have removed the shadows of the king geo from the pond geo. Now the next thing would be to remove the shadow and reflection of the king geometry from the ground. So again, bringing back the floor here, and I'm going to create another tray set. I'm going to add the floor to the pass through, adding tray set king, and I'm going to add tray set into the camera. So now you can see the detail of the king geo completely invisible to the camera rays in the render. It is only visible to the reflection, which is on the mirror. So if I go to the specular indirect, there is no info here in the specular indirect. So one thing I noticed here is that even though we have removed the king from the camera visibility, it's casting its shadow on the reflection of the pond. So in order to remove that, I need to again add the king tray set, which we have connected onto the pond geo's rayswitch geometry. I have to add the same tray set into the specular reflection as well. So now you can see we are getting the reflections here. So similar thing, I have to do this for the reflection in the mirror. Now what I'm seeing is that I'm also seeing some darkness on the reflection of the king geo. I had to like double check from where this issue is coming from. I had to change the shaders and check like if it is coming from any shader tweaks or where did I do wrongs. So then I found out that I have kept a raydepth of 1. Since we have only using raydepth value of 1, it will reflect only once. So the first bounds of reflection will be the mirror. But the thing is that we are seeing the reflection of the king geo on the floor in the mirror, as well as mirror's reflection on the floor. So the number of reflection bounces are higher than 1. So for that case, we have to increase the specular to 2. So now you can see that we have got our render as expected. We are clearly getting the reflections properly, the shadows properly. So since I have changed the material of the floor to metallic to double check where I was going wrong in here. So let me bring that reflection back to normal and make the surface a bit rougher so that we can get some shadows as well. So now you can see that our shadows are proper, the reflections are proper. There is no shadow casting between these two objects. This is how you can use rayswitch and tray sets to create some interesting renders like this. I encourage you to try this or any different kind of output similar to this. Do like open your creative mind and explore the endless opportunities which rayswitch shader provides, and let me know what you find out more than this from your side. And if you find anything more creative than these kind of things, do let me know by adding the shader links or the way of methods on the comments. I'll be more than happy to check that out as well, and I'll be more than happy to know that you have tried this and you have found out more. So this is as far as I am going to go in this tutorial. So once again, thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you learned something useful. If you liked it, please give a like to the video, share your thoughts in the comments, and subscribe to my channel. Share it with your friends who are also interested in lookdown and lighting. Also, if you want to learn about any particular topic inside Maya and Arnold, do let me know that as well in the comments. I'll see you with another exciting tutorial again soon. Till then, take care. Bye.